Hello everyone, today in this tutorial we are going to learn how to create a simple web application with the help of both React as well as Java, React at frontend and Java at backend. So for that I just took an example of simple books related data here, that is like some data will be there related to books, that is like name and author, some fields of the books, and those things will be adding to the database through Spring, as well as we are retrieving the books as well, and we can even update the books, the data about the books, and even in that books we can have one field like published field here. So that is like book is published or not, we can able to change that. So all those things we can able to do here. So that is our simple example. Before that, we are going to learn about the architecture here. So basically, whatever may be the web application we take, we'll be having three-tier architecture here. The typical three-tier architecture, which includes here, the first one would be the presentation layer here. So the presentation layer means the interface through which a user will be connecting to the application here, whatever may be the application. To that application, user will be connecting only through presentation layer. User cannot access directly other layers here. And the next one would be here, the application layer, and then followed by data layer or database layer, this one, or we can call it as a database layer here, or people will call it as persistence layer also here. Yeah, when it comes to the application layer here, the main business logic will be written, and we call it as business layer also here, and all the data which has to be stored permanently in the database layer, we'll be using some database to store the data here. So for example here, we are taking MySQL as database here, and for application layer, so developing the server side applications, so to render the data and to capture the requests which are coming from the front end, we will be using some server side programming here. So that is either Java or .NET or Python or something like Node we can use, and we are sticking here with Java with Spring Boot framework here. And when it comes to the presentation, that is called UI, presentation layer, front end part, we can use either Angular based or we can even use React or something like that. So without using framework also we can develop, but if you are using framework, that would be a very responsive site we can able to create here. So this is about a typical three-tier architecture about any web application. So here what happens, from this front-end layer, people will be calling some request. That request will be sent to the server here, this side. Application layer, there the request will be processed, and if required it will be hitting the database, and the data will be retrieved from the database, and the same one would be transferred to the presentation layer, that is like our web page, user's web page, people can able to see that one. So this is about the normal architecture and how the flow continues here. And now we are going to see our applications architecture here. So that is like we are going to use both React and Java, Spring Boot with MySQL. So in React we are going to create some components here, some book, right? So book related components, book data, something like books list component, book component, add book component, edit book component, like that we are going to create some components in the React here. And next, a router will be creating in the React. So router is used to navigate between the different components here. Whenever a page loads through React, usually a basic starting component will be loaded here, app component. The main component will be loaded, but if we want to transfer between the components and all, we will be using something like a router here. And all these are predefined things will be there in the React. We'll be just downloading and we'll be importing them and we'll be working with them. All the modules are available there here in the node. And next comes your services. In using service, whatever the implementation we wanted to achieve, the main implementation, we are going through service here. And when it comes to the sending the request and receiving the request here, receiving the response here, so we have to use a lightweight server to send the request and to receive the request here. So some certain module has to be there to transfer the request as well as response here. So for that to happen, so HTTP is required. So there are certain third-party things are available to achieve this, and one of them is here Hetzios. We can able to simply import this module called, download this module called Hetzios, and then we can able to establish such connection here. And next, when it comes to the Spring Boot here backend, whatever the requests which are coming here, this one, these are the requests which are coming here, those will be handled in this REST controller. And as per the link, that particular method will be executed here. That is, like, if you are trying to only get the data, then only get related methods will be executed here. And when we are going to something like get like this, or when you are going to set the data, that is something like some posting the data, we want to post something into that one, then that kind of method will be called here. So for all such responsibility will be taken care by the Spring REST controller here. And next, when it is required to connect with the database, Spring JPA is the one where which will be having so many built-in features will be there here. So if we are using normal JDBC, there we have to write so much of lines of so many lines of code, so much of configurations we have to do there. So instead of that, if you are using Spring JPA, so as it is already having some predefined things, repositories and predefined functions will be there related to those repositories, and we can create JPA REST repositories, we can able to create, and simply we can able to work that. So that is very useful. So for that we are using that, and that will be directly connected to our database here. So the storing the data into the database and getting some data from the database, and to do some update into the database and all, or to delete the contents in the database also, will be done with the help of this Spring JPA here. And the next is here we are going to develop this application in three stages here. That is, first we will be developing our backend services here. So that is, like, our backend part we will be developing first here. That is Spring along with the database connections and the repositories and all, will be first developing them. Then we'll be simply creating one front end for that, and then we'll be connecting both of them. So the first part is developing the Spring here, Spring related backend application we are going to develop here. So in this, what we are going to do here is some classes, Java classes, and some Java controllers and services. All these things are nothing but Java classes only. We'll be using, we will see now how we are going to use NL, but we are going to create them, and then as per that we are going to create a API here. So web service REST API we are going to create. So API is nothing but here, so certain links, certain APIs we are creating with certain resource links here. So that is, like, if somebody as a client enters some URL and all, so whatever the URL is entering, as per that operations will be performed at the back end here. So something like this here, and few things will be from year to year, and few things will be from year to year. So like this, we are going to develop certain API here. So once we are developed this full-fledged API, next we can able to connect this API to any front-end here. We can able to connect it to either Angular, we can connect, or we can even connect it to React also. Yeah, like this here. Yeah, so assume like here, so as we are developing the REST API, means here total four kind of things will be there. You might be knowing about this thing, that is like get kind of thing, get will be there, and post activity will be there, next some deletion activity will be there, and something like here update activity will be there here. So for updating purpose, we'll be using something like here, put here, get post, put and delete here. So here the same one will be applying to our application. So that is, if you take this as example here, so this is like a post kind of thing here. So means somebody is using the form, and there people are entering the data, and the data will be transferred into our application here. And next, this is like a get here, something like a get. So here, if they are trying to enter something like some URL, like some slash books or something, then example I am telling, okay, something like this, then all the data will be retrieved here. Here this is also get, but with some specific data here. So not all the books, I want to retrieve only a specific book here. Then something like this, example I am writing, so books slash some your book ID, something like 2 or something 4, and then only that book will be retrieved here. And if you are typing something like books here, then what happens, the total all books will be retrieved here. This is about different request which will be coming from the front end here. As per that, response will be generated here. Not only that, we can even have something like here update also. If you want to do update also, there must be a specific record which you wanted to update here. So I want to update the record number 1, first record, then we can able to do here. And so many things. If you want to delete also, if I want to delete one record, then we will be having like this, and delete will be there, and with one specific thing. No, I want to delete all of them, then that also we can able to do directly. We have something like delete. These are the different kind of operations could be performed on our application here. So this is what our application here. So this is our Java Spring Boot application. So this, and here we'll be using database, right? MySQL database we are going to use. So all these together, the entire thing is called our backend project or backend here. Simply we can call it as backend. And to test this, whether it is working properly or not, what to do? So one way is, we have to create a front end, we have to create, and from that we have to perform such operations like your post, get, delete, update, and all these operations we have to perform here, right? But before developing any front end, assume like you are the only back end developers, and then what we'll be doing, first we'll be developing our application. And as we don't know how, if we assume like we do not know how to develop the front end and all, still we can able to test our application here, our backend application, with the help of a tool here. One application tool is there, that is called here Postman. So using this, we can able to test our application, our backend application, we can able to test here. So with that, all these different URLs, that is different requests, we can make through Postman. So now what happens is, this Postman temporarily this Postman will be acting as a front end for you, and using that different requests will be sent, and those requests will be served here, and whether that is properly working or not, we can able to check here.
If you are entering normally the data in the forms through our front end, the way the data is generated in the same way, we can able to generate the data through Postman. We can able to send it, we can able to retrieve it, and all the operations we can able to perform through this Postman here. So this is about our backend architecture here. So how we are going to develop, what we are going to develop here. And next comes here your front end architecture. So I told you, right, certain components like book component and book list component, certain components here I just mentioned few components like that we'll be developing. If you are coming up with a huge requirement, and there will be having some n number of components in there, but as I told you, we are going to develop a small medium scale application, small application here. So that's why I took only three components here. Book component means the data book related things, and book list, books list, and how we are going to add book, these components will be there. And here first we are going to develop one React application. First we'll be launching a React application, and then we are going to inject a router into that application, and using that router only we can able to navigate through different components here, either book or book list or add book. Which component has to be activated, that would be decided with the help of this router, and how that router will be activated, how those links will be generated is simply with the help of those buttons and something like that. URL will be changing, somebody clicking that save it and update it, something like click it, something like add it, something like that will be there, right? So using which these things will be generated, URLs. As per that URL, the respective component will be activated. So once these things are done, then we have one thing is that something like to control these requests, we have something like a service will be there. So some books data or book related service or book service or whatever it is, some service will be there, where if somebody is enter something like books with ID and all, then what happens here, a book will be stored here. So book will be stored, so that is like storage related data. If somebody is normally entering books, that only books list will be generated simply, and if somebody is entering add book and a new book will be added, or something like that, or books with ID means not only this one, something adding that, something like updating and deleting also will be done with this book here. And books in this books list, we can able to only represent the list of books here, and in add book we are going to add new one. So for this to happen here, book data service will be handling those request here from the front end itself. So and but this is the one through which we are going to send the request to the external API. The external API here is nothing but, just now we discussed, right, few minutes back, that is our backend REST application here, this one. So after the application we are going to create, this one would be acting as a backend API for our front end here. So whatever the API we can use there, and the request will be sent to that API, and as per that request that will be processing such data, and if required the response also would be generated here. And for this to happen, all this HTTP protocol will be activated here, and for this to activate and for this to happen, all this routing has to happen properly and all. For that purpose here we will be using a third party thing, something like here a module will be using, that is called Axios module will be using here. So this is about our front end here. So that is our React architecture, in detail architecture about our React here.